Hello guys, this is Steven here. Now in this video I'm going to introduce you to ArcGIS Pro, and if you are using ArcMap then I'm going to also show you how you can quickly switch from ArcMap to ArcGIS Pro. Now ArcGIS Pro is a 2D and 3D mapping platform from Esri, and ArcGIS Pro, in fact, it's meant to take over from ArcMap, and it makes it easy to work with 2D and 3D, as I said, and also makes it easy to work on your desktop and your online, your ArcGIS desktop and ArcGIS online. It makes you to work between these two at the same time. Okay, now ArcGIS Pro has an easy to use interface, giving you all the tools that you mostly use when doing GIS. Okay, so now let's get right into let's just get ourselves into ArcGIS Pro. Okay. Okay, so now this is interface of ArcGIS Pro. Okay, so now the first thing that you would notice whenever you open your ArcGIS Pro, okay, is that you need to log in. Okay, so unlike ArcMap where you can use it right away once you have licensed the software, with ArcGIS Pro you have to log in before you, well, you have to log in to connect, you have to log in, of course, to use it most of the times. Okay, most of the time, because you can also use ArcGIS Pro offline, so it's not completely online based. Okay, you can also use it offline, and I'll show you how to send your ArcGIS Pro online. Then you can have access to all the projects that you've been working on. Now, if it's your first time using ArcGIS Pro, then you will not have any recent project open, but I have worked on a couple of projects, and then you have them shown here. Now also you have all the ArcGIS desktop component that you need, so the map catalog and then the scene. Now you'll notice that in ArcMap, okay, these were ArcGIS, ArcMap, ArcCatalog and then ArcScene respectively. Okay, so you have the same things that you need over here. Okay, so everything has been, you know, put together into the Pro, so you don't have to have all these things separate. Like you have to line global scene separately and you know, all that. Okay, now let's go into the settings. Okay, so before you use ArcGIS Pro, okay, you can take advantage and then customize some of the settings. Okay, so for instance, okay, so portal, nothing really much. Okay, so this shows you your login information. Now let's look at line sensing. Okay, so now for those of you who are very much familiar with the ArcGIS ecosystem, you realize that their desktop software come in three basic licenses. I mean, three different licenses. We have the basic license, standard, and then advanced. Okay, so I would always encourage you to go in for the advanced so that you enjoy the full capabilities of ArcGIS. The basic normally has some restrictions. You're unable to do editing and publishing data, and then the rest. Okay. Now you also have additional Esri extensions. Now these extensions are enabled in ArcGIS Online. Okay, so with the ArcMap, okay, you can enable these extensions when you are installing and licensing the software, or you can do that in the ArcGIS administrator. But with the Pro, you have to enable all these licenses in ArcGIS Online. And of course, you use the same account that you use to log into ArcGIS Online to log into ArcGIS Pro. So that is one thing that I like about the ArcGIS suite of software. You only need one license to be able to log in. And then I told you that you can take ArcGIS Pro to work offline. Okay. So now one thing you should notice is that when you take ArcGIS Pro offline, then you will not be able to log in or use. You will not be able to, once it's taken offline, you cannot be able to do some administrative things online like enabling licenses and then all that. Okay, so that's that. So you can also go to the options, and now the options basically has to do with you making settings or making changes to the default things that comes with the software. Okay, so every software has its default settings. Okay, things that exist without you, interfere or changing or doing any changes. So the things that exist with the software when it comes out of the box. Okay, so you can, or you'll be able to, change some of the settings. Okay, but I think I normally use most of these things by default without tampering with them. Okay, and then a whole other things. Okay, so now let's go back to the interface. And of course, you can have access to some learning resources. Now, let's start with a new blank map. Okay, I'm going to create a new blank map in ArcGIS Pro. Okay, so I'll click on map, and then it asks me to create a new project. So I'll call it ArcGIS Intro. Okay, ArcGIS Intro. And then I can specify a location where I want to save my project. Okay, so I'll keep it in the default folder. Now, when you use ArcMap, you realize that ArcMap always have a default folder. So if you run certain processing, geoprocessing tasks, or you create new documents and new maps, and you don't specify a save location, it's going to do that to you by default. So I'll say okay. A project file. Okay, so it already exists. Let me change it to ArcGIS. Let me just call this I'll just say intro to ArcGIS. Okay, I think okay, so I'll just say ArcMap, okay, to ArcGIS Pro. Okay, so ArcMap to ArcGIS Pro. ArcMap to ArcGIS Pro, and I'll say okay. So I save my work, and I create my project. Now, in ArcGIS Pro, every new work that you create, it's a project. Okay, so I've created a project in ArcGIS Pro. Everything is a project. Okay, so it will take some time to load my map, of course. Yeah. Okay, so depending on the speed. Okay, the speed of your computer, this could take some seconds, okay, to a minute or two sometimes to load. Okay, so I'll normally recommend that in your best of interest, you go in for maybe use a machine which is at least 4 gig RAM. Okay, 4 gig RAM if it is not loaded. Okay, but if you use your computer for a lot of things, then I would advise you going for an 8 gig RAM. Okay. So I have my map open. Okay, so my new ArcMap has been opened, and now ArcGIS Pro, okay, Once you create a project, it comes with a base map. This you don't see in ArcMap. Okay, this is one difference. In ArcMap, you have a white interface. Okay, you just have a white interface like this. Okay, that's what you see in ArcMap, unless you decide to bring in a base map. And when you bring in base maps, most of the time they load slowly and they slow down your machine. So let me turn back my layers, my base map layers. Okay, now I'm going to take you through the various menus and then toolbars in ArcGIS Pro. So now the first I'm going to take you through is the map. Okay, now in ArcMap you have a lot of toolbars. Okay, you have a lot of menu and then tool stuff. Okay, and I think the team has done a great job by streaming all these things to the basic things that you need. Okay, so I think ArcMap is too loaded with too many stuff which you don't use. So these things have been kind of like compact to make them, few but very useful. So under map, you can do stuff like exploring. You can do basic things like bookmarking, moving to a location. And then, of course, you can change a base map, okay? So you have access to a base map, and then you can switch to a base map. Okay, so I'm loading a new base map. So I have an imagery. And then you can add data. Okay, so you can add data directly to ArcGIS Pro. And I think this is one very useful tool in ArcMap. And then you can add data, add XY point data. So this option allows you to load an Excel, specify its X and Y. You know, in ArcMap, you have to drag a spreadsheet data and then display the points and then export and then all that. But this makes it very simple. Okay, and then of course your usual selection, measure to locate, coordinate conversion. Okay, these things are some new add-ons. Okay, and then you can also download your map. I've never tried this before. And then let's move to insert. Okay, so now you realize that in ArcMap, you know, you have the option to switch between a map and a layout. Okay, you had these icons over here somewhere here which you could do, but over here you can see that it is here. You can insert a map, a scene and stuff. Now one thing about ArcGIS Pro is that you can have multiple map interface open. You can even have a mixture of a map and a scene. Okay, unlike ArcMap where you only have one map instance, in ArcGIS Pro you can have multiple map instances. Great. Now toolbars, you can add a folder connection and then all that. And you have these other things. Okay, write map modes and blah blah blah. Okay, so you can take time and then explore some of these things. Of course, it also depends on the kind of data that you are working with. Now analysis. Okay, so now ArcGIS Pro presents you with analytic tools. Okay, so things that you mostly use. Okay, so you have these default stuff like buffer, summarize within, spatial join, and you know, you have some summarized data overlay features like clip, intersect, union, spatial join, proximity, analyze patterns, terrain, regression, manage data. Okay, so now you see that these things, these tools, these analytic tools have been selected. Okay, because these are things that you use most of the time when working with data. Now again, how you use these tools also is determined by the kind of data that you will be working with. Okay, so business analysis, network analysis, visibility analysis. Okay, so if you use any of these analytic tools in your work, you can take some time and then exploit. We'll try and do that in a future video or tutorial. Now let's go to view. Okay, so view basically does nothing aside from showing you certain tabs and panes that you use. For instance, you can open the geoprocessing. Okay, geoprocessing tool. You can auto hide this, you can dock it and then all that. You can open the Python window contents, okay, the contents as it appears here, catalog view. So the view, as its name implies, basically allows you to view some tabs and then others. Now you have the edit tool. Okay, so now edit tool basically allows you to gives you all the necessary tools that you need to create features, modify features, select, and then all that. Now, how you used to do editing in ArcMap, okay, it's basically the same process, okay, creating features, modifying, editing the attribute table, okay, editing geometry, and then all that, okay. So they are basically the same things. You only have to understand that how they do the things are a bit different in ArcMap. Now I'll show you this thing when doing editing. Okay, you can turn on grid. Okay, so grid allows you to kind of like have these horizontal and vertical lines. Okay, to grid your map, and sometimes it is useful when you are doing editing. Okay, and then you can have a lot of these grids to serve as guides and then snapping and then all that. Okay, so basically, yeah. Now let's move to imagery. Okay, so now imagery also allows you to gives you access to tools which you can use to perform some analysis or some calculations on your imagery. Okay, like a raster calculation and then all that. Okay, but you need to have an imagery data to be able to take advantage of this menu tools here. Let's move to share. Okay, so now after you are done with your map, after you've done all the things that you need to do, you need to be able to share your data. Okay, now you can share a web tool you've created, a locator, you can share a web map, you can also share a web layer. Okay, so you can choose to publish a web layer and override. You know, in the ArcMap you had the menu here where you can just open and then have the share where you can share your work and then go through all the necessary tags and then all that. But over here you have this option to easily share, publish a web layer directly, and then all that. And then you can also create a mobile map package. I have not really tried that. Okay, and then you also have this deep learning tool. Okay, you can create a new deep learning. Okay, so you can pretty much do a lot of stuff, and you can also go ahead and directly print your map, and then of course you can also export your map file, to a disk, as a PNG or something. Okay, as a picture and then all that. Okay, so you can also do that, and then of course you also have this appearance for doing other stuff like masking, symbology, and then a whole lot of stuff. Okay, so basically these are the menus and then the tools. I think this is much simplified. Okay, it gives you exactly what you need. Okay, and try to avoid all this long and ambiguity and then I don't know what I'm saying, but it allows you to avoid a whole lot of unnecessary, staff, tools, and then all that, and just give you what you need and then to work with, okay, directly. Okay, so of course, under your contents, you can list data by source, by editing, and I think you should be familiar with these things in ArcMap. Okay, let's go to the catalog. So catalog, you have the projects. So the current project you are working on, if you are working with any maps, you see them. If you are working with any tools, you see them. Databases, folders, and then locators. Then you also have the portal. Okay, so the portal opens the data. Okay, it opens the data that you are working with. It connects directly to your portal. That's your ArcGIS Online or ArcGIS for server, and shows you all the folders that you have. So we can see that clearly you can even have access to you can have access to all the projects that you have done, and you can bring them directly and then all that, okay. And then your favorites and then all that. Then lastly, okay, once you go to projects, you can save your map. Okay, when you decide to save your map, okay, ArcGIS Pro has a different extension. Okay, I think it's PPTX, which stands for project or something, as compared to MXD in ArcMap. Okay, so you can save your work and then all that. Okay, so guys, I hope you learned something. Okay, this is not meant to be an ArcGIS Pro tutorial or learning, but this is just to help you to get your feet into ArcGIS Pro if you are new, and then also to be able to switch to ArcGIS Pro from ArcMap easily. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll make the video available on my YouTube channel, okay, so that you can also go there and subscribe and then watch my video. So all the best, see you again. Bye.